Fat Boy belt, the last belt you'll ever buy until you need the other color.
Yeah.
All English tan harness leather, hand sewn buckles, stiffener in the belt, in here with Kydex stiffener, solid brass hardware. Will not set the alarm off at TSA. Even if you're pulled aside and hand wanded,
yeah,
you can wear this belt right on through. As long as you got it covered, because some of them will make you take it off to see it.
Yeah.
But it will not detect that little bit of brass.
I love that belt. It's like a quarter inch thick.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, it's English tan harness leather. So I got about three different thicknesses in belts. But I do a few holsters. Play with a lot of guns. Trunks and cases, for that matter. I do a little bit of everything. But my bread and butter is the Fat Boy belt. You can check
now,
the videos out on YouTube.
And you also have Two Fools Leather Goods.
Two
you guys,
Fools Leather Goods.
It's the other,
other
side project. And I know you've got some special projects there that you make at Two Fools Leather.
Yeah.
Everything. I talked to you last year. I don't think I did a very good job of getting a video.
It was pouring rain.
It was pouring rain. And everything is custom stitched.
Yeah.
Now a lot of people will buy these for horses, but you can also, I think you mentioned backpacking with these.
I've half sold these smaller ones, and one smaller than this guy's put them on Harleys.
Yeah, I was going to mention that, Harleys.
Yeah,
Very.
I sometimes call it my shit bag, because if you know your pickup truck, all that shit you got laying in the seat, you hit the brakes and it falls out on the floor.
Yeah.
You put it all in here, and when you hit your brakes,
it's
just
all
this
in there.
You only got one thing to pick up.
Yeah. And it's a lot better. It's a lot better than I don't know. I call them a lot of times you'll see people now with these things that it's a leather product that's been around for
1700.
Now you got guys with the European handbags for men, or I don't care if it's camo or what it is, a purse is still a purse, but this is not a purse.
No,
this is something that's been around forever.
English, and it's all English tan harness, just like my belts. Same leather I use in them. That way, if you have that thing out in the rain and a few drops of rain get on it, or a bunch of rain, it'll spot. But as soon as it dries, it'll go back just like that.
Yeah, and it's the water resistance is specifically due to the type of leather it is. So you couldn't just take
the fat and the tallow is forced back into the leather tanning process, which gives you that waxy feel, which gives you the water.
So this is the harness leather.
Yep. Just like the belt.
Nice. Nice. You do excellent work.
Thank you.
And the belts, I do like the belts too, you know. I wish we would have had the video last year would have turned out a little bit better, but it was rainy, noisy.
Right.
And at least now we'll be able to do a decent video for you so people can see your product. I do really like these bags.
Yeah. I tell you what, I've made over 100.
Nice.
Over the last 25.
Let's take a look at some of your hand-stitched holsters.
That's what is that? That's for an XDS. But they've got a different clip that I make. The clip, you can carry it 4 o'clock, 3 o'clock. I got some skinny boys that carry it, appendix carry.
Yeah.
But there's enough cut where you can turn it that way and carry it also as a cross draw for when you ride.
Yeah.
And it's all horse, 100% horse hide, hand stitched, reinforced neck, mouth. Retention on them is... You don't ever have to worry about your gun falling.
Yeah, go ahead and shake that upside down there and see how well it's...
You don't ever have to worry about the gun coming out.
Nice, very nice.
Same way with my... This is a shark skin, not quite done still, like the slots for the belt, but that's a new shark skin.
I just want to mention to everybody, there's a gray sheen on all of these things today. Every gun we go to, from the holsters to the belts, it is so dusty out here. They haven't had any rain up here for 3 months here in North Georgia.
Is dusty.
So that's the gray sheen you see on a lot of products and a lot of the different guns we've looked at today.
And then we've always got shoulder rigs.
All right, now your shoulder rigs.
Which is a standard tilt.
Snowboarding.
Give me that. All right, this is the officer's model, actually. But
yeah.
You don't have to worry about this gun. If you're carrying it down, you don't have to worry about running or bending over, kicking the log in the fire.
Yeah, yeah.
That your gun doesn't fall out on the ground.
All right, now that's going to, when you wear that, that's going to be a
shoulder rig.
Kind of a shoulder rig, but it's going to be a vertical or semi-vertical.
Yeah.
It's not going to be a horizontal.
Well, but it can lock, or you can wear it up like this.
Yeah, yeah.
With it locked up.
Very
double
nice.
Mag holder.
And this part here is going to clip around your belt.
Clips around your belt.
It from moving around.
The suede makes it lock in.
Yeah.
You don't have to, and that way you don't have to have a strap on the other side.
Very nice. Very nice. Because I know a lot of the other holsters do have some kind of a strap or something coming down.
Yeah, I try to go as minimal of that as I can. It
yeah.
just adds extras to them. You have to, on something like this, you have to be able to hook to your other belt.
Now this is fancy. It's almost like a James Bond rig.
This is the Ferguson grocery shopping rig. This is what all the soccer moms up in Ferguson, Missouri wear to the shopping center when they're out hunting. When they're out hunting groceries.
Yeah.
It takes a sawed-off shotgun under the right arm, here with your mags and extra shell, over
yeah.
your left. So it's it can be handled anywhere in protection.
You know what? There is a shotgun somebody is selling right now. It's a three. Is it a, I think it's a three-round pump?
Uh-huh.
Have you seen it? And it's sold as a pistol.
Oh, it's the Serbu. Yeah.
That would be.
It fits.
Yeah. That would be. So the Serbu will fit in here.
Yes,
three round pump.
Had it in there. We're walking
yeah.
around with it in their shorts.
Nice.
Actually, they sold one like that to somebody down there. Moss did.
Nice.
That had.
I'm gonna have to look at that.
Mm-hmm.
That would be so awesome.
Yeah, I've also done it with the MP5.
I would want to, you know, I would want to carry this with the Serbu in it, a pistol and everything, and just walk through somewhere that has a metal detector just so I could start laying everything out like to do on TV.
Yeah.
You know, just so they could see me unloading everything. Who is this guy?
Yeah, it's supposed to be James Bond. Security.
Yep. Yeah. That gives you options.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it gives you all the options you want. You can use any firearm you want up here at the top. I mean, I can make it for any.
Yeah, any handgun at all.
Yeah,
so if you were somebody carrying it, whether this stuff,
yeah.
we were just looking at the IMI Jericho or
yeah.
the Smith & Wesson
yeah.
or something, you'll look
right.
at any custom made.
Over here can be, like I say, a sawed-off pump or automatic.
Nice.
Semi-auto or a double barrel, I think is one I'm going to do one for. I'm looking for a little double barrel now to saw off and put in one of them.
I wish I had, but I actually passed on a double barrel cap lock
yeah.
Pistol that was at a flea
mm-hmm.
market. And I wish I hadn't passed on it. It was a parts gun.
Yeah.
It would have been an interesting project for that, for something like that. That
mm-hmm.
would have been interesting.
Yeah, it would.
All right, guys, this is Jin's Boy 2003 talking with my friend Curtis here at Fat Boy Belts, also Two Fools Leather. So don't forget to go onto his website, look for him online. You can Google him and you can check, get the belts, you can get holsters. Everything's custom made, handmade, and just contact him and he'll make probably anything you need.
Yep.
All right, thanks.
Thank you, man. Appreciate it.